If you work in Angular and haven't heard yet, many things are in the process of switching away from decorators over to signals. I've already shown you how component or directive inputs have changed over from the input decorator to signals with the input function. In this video, we'll take a look at how we can convert the viewChild and contentChild decorators over to signals with the viewChild and contentChild functions. We'll take an example application that I previously created for a video demonstrating how to use the viewChild and contentChild decorators, and we'll switch them over to the new signal functions, producing the same end result. Okay, let's get to it. So here's the demo application that I was talking about. It lists out a searchable list of NBA players. We have created three examples. One where we use the viewChild decorator and a template reference variable to select the HTML input element for our search field in order to focus it on initialization. Then we have another example also using the viewChild decorator along with a component to focus the search form on initialization, but when it's nested within another component. And for the final example, we use the contentChild decorator to focus the search field when it's been included within projected content. And in this video, we'll convert each of these over to signals using the viewChild and contentChild functions. Okay, let's start with the viewChild and template reference variable DOM element example. Okay, here in this example, we can see in our search component, we have the viewChild decorator that queries for a template reference variable named searchField. And if we switch over to the template, we can see the variable on our search input here. Okay, let's switch back to the code. A couple more things to note. We've also made this decorator static because we know it will always exist. When we do this, it becomes available earlier in Angular's component lifecycle events, so we're able to set focus in the ng-on-init hook here. If it wasn't static, we'd need to add it in the ng-after-view-init lifecycle event instead because it wouldn't be available until the view is ready. Okay, now that we understand what's going on here, let's switch to the viewChild function. This function is part of a set of what are known as signal queries in Angular. These queries are used to find child components, directives, or DOM elements. If we're searching for something directly within the component template, then we're using the view. In contrast, if we're searching for something that will be inserted within a content slot, we're using content. In this case, since we're dealing with the component view, this function is considered a view query. Anything dealing with the projected content would be considered a content query. We'll see an example of this later on in the video. Okay, to use the viewChild function, we'll create a private variable that we'll name searchField. Since we're going to replace our existing searchField property, it'll be named the same for now. We'll remove the old one once we're done. Then we just add the viewChild function and we'll need to type it to an element ref HTML element. Okay, now we can remove the old variable set with the decorator and we can remove the decorator import too. Then all we need to do is, since this property is now a signal, we need to add parentheses where we're using it. And that's it. If we save, we should see that our search field is focused on initialization, just like it was before the change. And there we go. So that works properly. Now, since this is a signal, we can switch this over to an effect instead of the ng-on-init lifecycle event. This will make it available as soon as the viewChild signal is set. To do this, let's add a constructor. Within the constructor, let's add the effect function. And within the callback here, we can move our focus call. Now we can remove our ng on init function, interface, and import to. Now we should be able to save and see this still working correctly. And there we go. Pretty cool. Okay, one more thing we can do here is, since we know that this field will always exist, we can make it required just like we can with the input function. We just add dot required. Now TypeScript will infer that this variable will always exist, meaning we no longer need the question mark here. Okay, that's it. If we save again, everything should work as expected. And it does. Cool. Now, this would mean that we'd get an error if this were to become conditional or something in the future. So that's the viewchild function querying for an HTML element. Now let's query for a component within the template instead. Here in this example, we have moved the search form to its own component. Then this search form component gets included in the parent search component. When we switch back over to the code for the search form component, we can see that we have our search field variable available as a public property so that it can be accessed externally by other components or directives. Now let's take a look at the code for the search component. We have an old viewchild decorator used to access the search form component within the view. It's also static like the previous example, and it's accessed in the ng-on-init lifecycle hook to set focus of the text field within that component. This example will be very similar to the last one, except we'll be using a component for our query instead of an HTML element. So let's add a new private variable named searchForm. Then we'll use the viewchild function again. We'll make it required. Then we'll pass it the searchForm component class. And that's it. Now we can remove the old property set with the decorator. We can remove the import for the viewchild decorator. Next, we need to add parentheses to the search form property. Next, we can add a constructor. Then we can add the effect function. Now we can move the focus call into the effect function callback. And last but not least, we can remove the ng-on-init function, the interface, and the import to. And that should be it. Let's save and make sure it's still working properly. There it is. Nice. So now we know how to query for both DOM elements and components or directives within the view. Up next, let's look at how we'd use the content child function to query for a component within projected content. Okay, in this example, we have our same search form component, but the parent search component has changed a little. If we look at the template, we can see that it has a content slot. So let's take a look at the app component template where this search component is used. Here we can see the search form component is included in the slot for the search component now. So it's projected content within the search component. So now to access this search form component from the parent search component, we'll be dealing with a content query. Let's look at the code for the search component. Here we can see that we're using the old content child decorator to create a static search form property querying for the search form component. So this is exactly the same as the last example, except we'll use the content child function in this case. So let's create a private field named search form. Then we'll use the content child function. We can make it required here too, since we'll always want to include it. And then we just pass the search form component class. Now we can remove the old property set with the content child decorator. We can remove the decorator import too. Now we can add a constructor. Then we can add the effect function. Then we can move the focus call into the effect. We then need to add parentheses to the search field property here. Okay, all that's left now is to remove the ng-on-init function, interface, and import. Cool. Now let's go ahead and save to make sure everything is working correctly. Nice. It's focused just like we want. So there you have it. Now you know how to use the new ViewChild and ContentChild signal query functions. They're not too much different than the old decorators, but you'll probably want to start using them moving forward to modernize your Angular applications, and now you'll know how. That's all for now. Thanks for watching.